had Hodgkin's disease when I was 16 years old. I think this is probably one of my, I guess, the biggest life event I've had. One of the biggest life events I've had. I guess my personal experience was I was told that to just get through the treatments. Once you get through the next, you know, kind of a year or so of radiation and surgeries and chemotherapy, that your life's going to go back to normal. And I think what I found out or experienced the rest of my life since then, which is, you know, almost 25 years later now, is that cancer is not, pediatric cancer or cancer itself is not an acute disease. It's a lifelong problem. And I think for most patients, this is probably the case. The treatments that I got consisted of, I got fairly non-focused radiation to my chest and my abdomen, and that was about 9 weeks total. After that, I got 8 different chemotherapy drugs over the course of about 9 months. It was a terrible experience, is what I would say. I lost about 65 to 70 pounds of weight. There was a 3-month period where I didn't eat at all. I had to get all my nutrition through IV, basically, because my intestines had stopped working optimally and I just couldn't tolerate any food. So fortunately, I made it through all that and survived. And I think what I learned after that, it was not over then. I think as a teenager, it's a time in your life where you're trying to overcome. You grow into adulthood, and a severe illness like that kind of turns your life upside down. So you're trying to do that and then deal with, you know, kind of mentally understanding what happened to you. So I went through a lot of, you know, during my college years, I think I thought a lot about what happened to me. And I think what angered me the most was actually the toxicity of the medications. I just didn't understand why the medicines that I had to take were so bad. I did, because I lived, but on the other hand, it just seemed like there could be a better way to treat cancer. And so I think as those thoughts developed, I got really interested in research and medicine and ultimately went on to become an MD-PhD student. And I started as an MD-PhD student really wanting to develop new chemotherapy drugs with the idea that they would be less toxic and it would be better for patients. What I've had during the period since I've been treated, I had a mild stroke a few years ago and was admitted to the hospital, and it was a very scary experience. I couldn't move half my body for about 15 minutes. One of the biggest problems I've had is actually a heart problem. So about 18 years after I was treated, I somewhat emergently had to have open heart surgery. So I had a heart valve that was badly damaged, was discovered. And during the workup for surgery, they told me it had to be replaced. And for the workup for that surgery, they also found that I had 3 of my coronary arteries were 95% blocked. So I went for surgery about a week later. I think that was a major life-changing event for me. And then I've developed kind of pre-diabetes, something that's been watched. It's something we know from survivorship studies can happen. And then I have infertility, which is something that I knew about. And thankfully, this goes back to a lot of the late effects that we see. If you are engaged in medical care and can advocate for your own care, the outcomes can be actually phenomenal. So I survived heart surgery because I was able to get care at a really good institution in Texas. And I was able to have children because I donated semen before I was treated with chemotherapy, and the technology improved, and my wife and I have 4 children by in vitro fertilization, because the technology has improved over the years. And so I think for many of the late effects that we deal with, even if patients get them, there's the opportunity to intervene and help them have a healthy life, provided that they're caught early and in time. I think my experience as a patient on some level is a little unique from being able to get care. And I think that's because I was a MD-PhD student, and I kind of was able to navigate the system and find the right doctors to take care of me. I never had a oncologist or survivorship doctor advocate for me. In fact, a lot of what I did was actually read the literature myself and say, I'd go into it was an adult oncologist that took care of me. And I would say, hey, I need an echo this year. I think I need a colonoscopy now because I have radiation in my abdomen. I need, you know, this, this, and this test. And we'd do it. And that's kind of how my survivorship care has been provided. I think for our patients, the vast majority of them are not in the medical field when you look at our patients. And so it's really important for us to educate them. And I think survivorship care plans, where we basically summarize their treatment history, summarize the late effects they need to worry about, and then also give them really definitive guidelines for follow-up care for each of these problems they might have, is extremely important, not only because it educates them, but you know, the idea is that they could go to a primary care doctor, like a family practice doctor or internal medicine doctor, who would then be able to, you know, read the survivorship care plan and kind of carry out the screening that needs to happen. The whole goal of which is to, I think, catch things like heart problems and high blood pressure and those things early, so that we can intervene and hopefully give them let them have a healthier life for a longer period of time. So I think in terms of survivorship care plans, a lot of the groups of physicians that are involved in oncology have recognized this is important, and there's literature coming out about how they're important. Studies have been done from a patient satisfaction standpoint. It's really important to them. But I think we're struggling at coming up with a uniform way to actually deliver these to the patients. And I think it's a really important thing that we have to change about survivorship care, is that we have to have people working in survivorship that are dedicated to that specific area of oncology. And then survivorship care plan is a big part of what they would do as their job. I think my story, is like kind of makes people take pause. And then understanding kind of the issues, having seen it as a physician, being involved in research, I think gives me a kind of a different perspective to able to hopefully convince someone that we got to do something about this.